Hi friends, I'm Urvashi. Welcome to my channel. Today in this video, I'm going to be talking about the Mars Rahu or the Mangal Rahu conjunction in Gemini in the year 2019. And at the same time, I will also be touching a little bit about this total Rahu Ketu axis in Gemini and Sagittarius. So before I start, for all those who haven't subscribed, remember to subscribe, remember to tap the bell icon. Only then will you receive any kind of a notification. So let's see what this conjunction is, what energy this conjunction will be bringing to our lives for the next month and a half. Because it's right from the 7th of May that Mars will be entering Gemini. And simultaneously Mercury is in Aries, so there is a parivartan yoga between Gemini between Mars and Mercury till about the 18th. This parivartan yoga will be there, and then on the 18th Mercury moves into Taurus. Mars continues to move in Gemini towards Rahu, so it's only around the 4th and the 5th of June that you know this conjunction becomes strong. And so the 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, these are certain dates we need to be cautious about till about the 13th, because Moon is also going to be there as a part of this conjunction. Mercury is also going to be in Gemini at that point of time, and Mars is going to be very close to Rahu. So this entire axis, you know, Gemini, Sagittarius is going to be afflicted with a lot of malefic planets. We have Mars there, Rahu there. Of course, the sign of Gemini is very activated with the the Lord of Gemini, Mercury in the same house, Moon is going to be there, and then we have Saturn, Ketu, and in the sign of Sagittarius. So this entire axis is very activated, and not in a very positive manner, because a lot of malefics are going to be, you know, afflicting this axis. So what does this mean? How do we see this energy, and what is the general effect of this energy is what I'm going to be talking about here. So to understand that, we first have to understand what Mars is and what Rahu is, and what happens when they come together. Of course, we've heard of the Angarak Yoga, but what really happens, who wins? Because this is a planetary war. This is a Graha Yuddha that we're talking about here. So let's talk about who wins and what happens. What is Mars? Mars is the muscle in our body. So it's that energy, that strength in our body. It helps us take all the actions that we want to take. It's also the mental muscle, I would say. It's the willpower. How determined, how mentally strong you are can be seen from the placement of Mars. I've been, other videos also talked about how, why do we say that if you have a well-placed Mars, you can go into the army or the police. It's because of this. Because in the army, the police, the kind of training those people have to undergo requires a lot of physical effort, and physical effort cannot be done without mental will, without the strength of will and determination. Because at some point of time, this physical exertion, you know, tends to kind of break you down. So for any strenuous physical activity, any strong, forceful physical activity, Mars comes into the picture. Mars signifies the blood in our body, it signifies the muscle in our body, it signifies the josh. In Hindi, I would say josh, or the passion. In English, it would be the passion that we feel. How passionate are you is seen from Mars. That is why whenever Mars is aspecting Venus, or Mars is in conjunction with Venus, such a person or such a native would tend to be very passionate about whatever they do, not just sexually. Sometimes this conjunction is taken negatively, but such a person is passionate about everything in life, and whatever they do, they will do it with a lot of passion. So Mars is, why do we say that if you are a Manglik, then you should get married after the age of 28? Because the energy of Mars gets matured, and one tends to simmer down. The hormones tend to settle down. The, you know, adrenaline rush kind of energy kinds, you know, it tends to settle down. So when Mars is not very mature, or Mars is afflicted, then that energy can, make us do a lot of illogical things. Why? Because Mars is also the planet of logic. Mars is the, he is the Senapati. He is the general of the armies of the Suras. And what is Rahu? Rahu is the general of the armies of the Asuras, of the demons. He's also a general of the army. And now here, both the generals, are moving towards each other. We must also understand that Rahu is in retrogression, moving backwards from Gemini from 30 degrees. So Rahu is almost at 24 degrees right now. When Mars is going to enter Gemini, Rahu will be at 24 degrees and they will conjunct at 23 degrees. So that will happen around the 5th and 6th of June when Mars comes very close to Rahu. They are within about 8 degrees of each other. So that is when Rahu and Mars are going to be impacting each other very strongly. Around the 10th to the 13th, this conjunction is very strong. And then they move away from each other because Mars is going towards the higher degrees, whereas Rahu is moving towards the lower degrees. So this Angarak Yoga is taking place at 23 degrees of Gemini Nakshatra of Punarvasu. So if you are ruled by the planet, by the Nakshatra of Punarvasu, if your moon is posited in Punarvasu, then you will feel a bigger impact of this conjunction. And what else does this show? Mars is your physical strength, your mental will. Mars is your fighting spirit. Mars can also be associated with speed. You know how youngsters are when they have a lot of energy, when the hormonal rush is very high, they like to drive very fast. That is the Mars energy. You want to express that energy in the outward world. One tends to drive very fast with a lot of Martian energy. Mars signifies your desires. Like I said, it is the planet for passion. Mars is also the significator of land and property. And Rahu here moving towards Mars in a Graha Yuddha, in a planetary war. So I'll let you guys guess for a couple of seconds. Guess who's going to win this planetary war, Rahu or Mars? So Rahu beats Mars in this planetary war. Why? Both of them are general of the armies. Mars is the general of the armies of the Suras, like I said, and Rahu is the general of the armies of the Asuras. So why does Rahu win the war between the two of them? You know, it's because Rahu backstabs. Rahu uses chal kapat. Rahu doesn't fight straight. Mars fights according to the rules and regulations of the war. Mars wants to be fair and square, but Rahu believes all is fair in love and war. So Rahu comes from the back and backstabs. And so that is why Rahu wins this war. Now what happens? So Rahu takes the energy of Mars and now Rahu is doubly strong. So we have this very, very strong, corrupt, malefic energy here. An energy that believes anything and everything is fair if one wants success. So, and this is happening in the sign of Gemini. So logic, because Mars is logic, like I said, so our logic will get corrupted. We will not be able to think straight in many situations. Our energy level, we will feel more enthusiastic, more determined, more strong to take any kind of action. Sometimes without logic, sometimes without applying logic, we will be taking a lot of illogical decisions and we will be running into situations. That is another thing that is going to happen. Sexual desires are going to be corrupted. You know, lot of aggression will be felt, especially if you are a Scorpio ascendant, because then this is happening in the 8th house. Or if you are a Cancer ascendant, because this is happening in the 12th house. Or even if you are an Aries ascendant, because even the 3rd house or the sign of Gemini is the natural sign for sexual activity, because it's the 9th from the 7th, 9th from Libra. If you start counting from the 7th house, then Gemini would be the 9th house, which is the dharma of marriage. So it also signifies sex. So Aries, Cancer and Scorpio, it can heighten aggressive sexual energy. It can lead one into extramarital relationships, into the wrong kind of relationships, aggressive relationships. It can, for all of us, it will tend to confuse us, confuse our logic. For some of us who want to buy property or want to move abroad, because Mars is also the planet of property, And Mars, if you know, when it comes in conjunction with Rahu, can take us or help us in buying property in a foreign land. So property related to foreigners, property in a foreign land. So those looking to buy property at this point of time, depending on the placement of Mars, this can happen during these 2 months. So 7th of May, Mars enters Gemini until the 22nd of June, Mars is going to be in Gemini with Rahu and then Mars moves out. But around the 15th on the 16th, of June, Mars is going to go away from this conjunction. Rahu keeps moving towards the lower degrees, Mars is moving towards the higher degrees. So this now is not so much of a yoga, this is more of a viyoga. So the yoga is breaking up. So whatever is going to happen will happen till about the 16th of June. So those are the days between the 5th of June, especially till the 16th of June, when this conjunction is very strong, they are moving towards each other. The 10th to the 13th, 14th, you got to be extremely careful of any decisions that you do, because logic is going to be confused. Rahu is going to take over your thinking ability, your logic. Rahu is going to make you more aggressive, more feel more energetic, more quick to take action. And that action may sometimes not be very logical. So Rahu is definitely going to enhance our, you know, determination, mental will, physical strength. Aggression is going to be heightened, emotions are going to be disturbed, especially during those few days when Moon, Mars, Rahu, Mercury is also going to be conjunct in the same house. So during that point of time, from the 5th of June till the 13th, 14th, I would suggest don't take any major decisions, because Mars is impacted by Rahu, Mercury is impacted by Rahu. Mercury is our intellect and Mars is our logic. Both of them are impacted by Rahu, and Moon is going to be a part of this conjunction. Emotions are going to be disturbed. So those days, do not take any major decisions. Do not get into any fights, any kind of aggression. And also here I would like to say, because this is happening in the sign of Gemini, and on the other side, of this axis, we have Saturn and Ketu in Sagittarius. Another thing that I personally feel is going to happen is, because lately we've seen a lot of violence going on around the world, especially now that we're having Saturn Ketu conjunction. Violence has always been there in the world, but in the last few days, in the last month or so, we've seen a lot of violence that has happened in churches related to religious places. And because the ninth house would, of course, is, you know, temples and religion and philosophy, higher learning, ethics, values. So a lot of things. And on the other side, we have Mars Rahu in the third house in the sign of Gemini. And the sign of Gemini is also how you perceive things. Your perception of a situation is the third house, is the sign of Gemini. In the natural zodiac, you go out and you experience the world, you gain knowledge. That is the third house. And the ninth house is philosophy, ethics, morality, religion, law, higher learning, things like that. And this entire axis is highly afflicted in this month and a half. It's already afflicted having Saturn, Ketu and Rahu in this axis. It's going to get worse with Mars in the picture. Then Mercury is also going to be joining Mars, and Moon is also going to be there for a few days, couple of days. So during this point of time, the disturbance in the world is going to, it's going to make a negative impact on our logic, on our intellect, on how we perceive the world. Because the third house, the sign of Gemini, is how we gain knowledge, how we perceive, our perception. And this entire axis is so afflicted that some of us, depending on the promise, of course, of the chart, depending on the dasha, it will impact some more, it will impact some less, but it is going to impact all of us, because it's happening in the natural zodiac, not on each of our personal charts. It's more about it's a mundane thing, more than, you know, on anyone's particular, you know, birth chart. But the effect will be that all this violence and a lot of publicity, lot of things that the media does to show, to, you know, gain leverage from this violence, to grow, to increase their, viewership, the way that it is going to be projected is going to impact a lot of minds, is going to make us, you know, I know many of us are already you know, thinking along lines where we start blaming a particular community or a particular religion for all the problems in the world. But that's not how things work or how things happen. It's always a few people who are teaching or preaching the wrong things that leads to a lot of negative things. But that is what I'm trying to say. During this time, our perception is going to be impacted. We may start perceiving things negatively and we may start feeling very aggressive. And some of us who are prone to such behaviors may be showing a lot of aggressive behavior during this point of time. So do take care about your perception. Whatever happens in the world happens. Violence goes on. It's always been happening. I'm not saying it's a good thing, it's a very bad thing, but as far as possible, we need to stay away from it. As far as possible, whatever little we can do, we can, you know, we should do a little bit to retain the peace in the world. But developing those hostile feelings against others, against particular communities, doesn't help the situation in any way. So ethics, morality, religion, law, philosophy are in question. And what has impacted your logic, your intellect, your thinking, your perception? A lot of minds may go towards the negative side during this point of time. And on a personal level, again, it's your perception. Again, higher values, philosophy, religion, what your fathers taught you may be questioned by you. What your guru, what your teachers teach you, values, ethics may be questioned by you. And you may be perceiving situations in a negative, illogical manner, showing aggressive behavior. Aggressive sexual behavior, aggressive, you know, physical behavior, driving too fast. When we are very aggressive, then we tend to do everything very quickly. We want to quickly do everything. So driving too fast, again, many of the zodiacs will be prone to accidents. Those that have this conjunction in the first house, Gemini, seventh house, Sagittarius, 6th house, Capricorn, 8th house, Scorpio. So these signs, and even the 9th house, that would be Libra and Aries, because it's happening in the 3rd house, because these are the houses of travel. So these people need to be a little careful about when they're on the road, about driving cautiously. And you generally need to be cautious about how you perceive things, how you perceive situations. And don't question don't question ethics at this point of time. Don't question what is right or what is wrong, because a lot of questioning is going to be happening in the world on a larger basis, on a larger scale, and a lot of questioning will be happening in your personal life, in your particular situations, where you may feel that other people are trying to control you, other people are telling you what to do, they are telling you these are ethics, this is the philosophy, this is right, you should stick to traditions, you shouldn't get married to such a person, you should not be doing this. So you are going to be questioning all of that, and there are going to be heated reactions from your end, from my end as well. So I feel we need to keep our calm, keep our cool, and be very careful on the road, and do not get swayed by a lot of things that you see on the media. And use your logic. Don't let Rahu cloud your logic, because Mercury, Mars are both going to be afflicted at this point of time. So those are my thoughts on this transit. And the best thing to do about this is meditate. I feel meditation is very important to calm the mind. 15 or 20 minutes of meditation is enough and helps you relax. If you can, you know, do some yoga or something, physical activity too is recommended, especially yoga. I love yoga. I feel yoga kind of, it aligns your body a little bit. So you're mentally and physically very aligned. So I would suggest do a little bit of yoga. In fact, you can do it regularly and meditate and keep calm. And especially during those dates that I gave you, do not take any important decisions. That's all for now. I will see you now in the next video. Bye-bye.